Hi, welcome to class. You'll need a strap. If you don't have a yoga strap, just use an old belt and a yoga block. If you don't have a yoga block, just get like a bed towel and fold it and fold it and fold it. And this will work for a yoga block. Our practice today is going to be a lying down practice. So if you are unable to get down on the floor, no worries. This practice will work perfectly well in the center of your bed, okay? So go ahead and get situated, stretch out, make sure you've got your strap and your block handy. We're gonna focus on our hip, our hips and our low back today. But if you have any, come on back here to the mat and stretching out. My block and my strap are handy here. Releasing into the floor or your bed. Take a moment here, once you've settled, to place one hand on the upper abdomen and one hand on your heart center. Close your eyes and turn your focus inward to the breath. Slow the breath and slow the mind. Feel the rise and fall of the chest and the belly as you slowly draw the breath in and release the breath out. Belly breathing is one of the foundations of our yoga practice, and it can take some time to make this an easeful practice. But belly breathing means that we're engaging the low lungs, so we're drawing the breath down into the belly. The belly rises first, and then the heart fills second. So take a moment to try this and see if you can gently pull the breath into the lungs so the hand on the belly lifts first, and then the hand on the heart rises second. As you exhale, soften and release your neck and shoulders, your back, your hips, your glutes. Bring your arms alongside you now. We're going to bend the legs at the knees and bring the soles of the feet to the floor. Place your hands on your lower abdomen. Big breath into the belly. Now as you exhale, pull your belly button in and feel the back flatten into the floor. Keep the back flattening into the floor, and then we're going to very slowly release the knees over to the right. Gentle twist in the torso. Big breath in here. Now as you exhale, draw the belly in, lift the knees back up, and exhale the knees over to the left. Gentle twist in the torso. Soften and release the low back. One round of breath here, and then big breath in. Exhale, pull the belly in, lift the knees back up, going back to releasing to the right side. Soften and release the muscles on the right glutes and the right hip as they're meeting the floor. Big breath into the belly. Exhale, draw the belly in, lift the knees up, and then release to the other side again. Now, focusing on the left glutes and hip, soften and release those muscles there where they meet the floor. Big breath in. Exhale, pull the belly in and lift the knees back up. So, if you're able to, we're going to take a big breath in and then lift your knees and take a hold of the knees. If you are not able to get your hands to the top of your knees, you could always use a strap and wrap that strap around the front of the knees. So right side of the strap is in the right hand and the left side is in the left hand. Let your elbows rest on the floor. You can work the pose from here with the strap if you're not able to reach the knees. Okay, so we're going to inhale and press the knees into the strap or resist the knees into your hands. So we're trying to pull the knees away and the hands are trying to hold them in place. Deepen the breath here. Now we're going to change the tilt of the pelvis. Release that tension and relax for a moment. Then pull your knees either with your strap or your hands and draw those knees just a little bit closer to you. Elbows on the floor if you're using the strap and resist the knees, push the knees into the strap. Just a little muscle energy working in the low back and the hips and the glutes. So the strap is being held steady, but you're pressing the knees into the strap, firing up muscle energy in your hips and glutes. One more round of breath here. And then soften and release. Allow the feet to come to the floor. Stretch the left leg out. And we're going to lift the right leg and place the strap at the ball of the foot. Right side is in the right hand. Left side is in the left hand. And very gently, very slowly, lengthen that leg and try to straighten it. I'm going to push out through the mound of my big toe and lengthen the line of the leg, softening and releasing the back of the thigh. If you're able to straighten the leg, then you might deepen the stretch by lifting the leg a little bit higher. Soften and release the back of the thigh, lengthen up through the mound of the big toe. Keep the breath flowing through. One more round of breath here. And then bend the knee, release the strap, switch sides. Straighten the right leg, bend the left, strap to the left foot. And we're going to secure that strap at the ball of the foot. Right side of the strap in the right hand and the left side is in the left. And then try to straighten that leg as much as you are able to. Lengthen out through the mound of the big toe. So if you don't feel much of a stretch in the back of the thigh here, go ahead and try to lift that leg a little closer to perpendicular to the floor. Soften and release the back of the left thigh. Keep the breath moving through. With the inhale, we expand. And then with your exhale, think about sending the breath to the back of that left thigh, softening and releasing the tension there. One more round of breath here. And then bend the knee, set the strap off to the side. Both legs straight, bring your arms out like a T. Big breath into the belly. Exhale, draw your belly in. Flex your feet and bring your arches together, ankles together. Flex the feet strongly so you've got muscle energy working in the lower legs. Press the palms into the floor. Bring a slight lift to your chin and press the head into the floor. Draw the belly in. Spread your fingers, press your fingers into the floor. Muscle energy humming through the whole body here. Press the heels into the floor. Draw the belly in strongly. Root the shoulders into the floor. One more round of breath here. And then soften and release. Allow all that tension that you created with the muscle energy to just flow away, relax. Now we're going to bring the right leg to bent. Right foot is in the is inside of the left knee. Right knee points straight up to the sky. Left hand comes across the body to that right knee. So left arm crosses to right knee. Big breath in. Exhale. Draw your belly in. Pull the knee over to the left and twist the torso. Keep your right shoulder down. Soften and release the hip on the right side, the glutes on the right side, the low back. Softening and releasing with the exhale. And then if you can get a little release in that right hip and glute, you might try drawing the knee a little closer to the floor or a little further over to the left. Deepen the breath here. And then big breath into the belly. Exhale, draw the belly in, lift the knee up, switch sides, straighten the right leg, bend the left. Left foot is on the floor, inside of the right knee. Now the right arm crosses the body to reach the thigh or the knee. You can lift that leg if you need to. Big breath in. Exhale, pull the belly in and bring that knee over. So we're rolling onto the left hip. I just popped my back. That felt really good. So we're going ahead and rolling over onto that right hip, lengthening and releasing the left glutes and the left hip. Keep your left shoulder down on the floor. Inhale, expanding, and exhale, soften and release the hips, the glutes, and the low back. Remember, keeping the breath moving through is equally as important as doing the pose. One more, well actually, if you got a little release here on the left side, you might try deepening the pose first by drawing that knee a little closer to the floor, a little further over. Now, one more round of breath here. And inhale, big breath in. Exhale, pull your belly in as you lift that knee up, stretch the leg out, arms alongside you. Take a moment to close your eyes and enjoy the breath. Big breath into the belly. Exhale, pull the belly in, bend the knees once more. Okay, find your yoga block or your towel. We're gonna bring the yoga block between the knees. You have options for how you do this. You can do it the skinny way, or you can do it here with about a 4-inch width between the knees. Feet are flat on the floor. The yoga block is between the knees. Bring your hands to the lower belly. We're gonna work with muscle energy here, but we're gonna start really light. So gently, squeeze your knees into the block. Just enough muscle energy that you can feel the groin working and you feel a little bit of work on the outer hips, maybe even in the lower belly. Just a little bit of muscle energy hugging into the block, and we're gonna do a 10 count. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release. You can keep the block there, but stop squeezing it and take a pause, focusing on your breath, a relaxing breath, pulling the breath in to the count of 3. Exhale to five. Okay, back to the knees. Hug the knees into the block. Maybe add just a tiny bit more muscle energy this time. Squeezing in, 10 count, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Pull the breath into the count of 3, expand. Extend your exhale to 5, soften and release. Okay, one more time, and add just even a little bit more muscle energy this time as you squeeze the knees into the block, fire up the groin, fire up the hips, and we'll do the 10 count, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Soften and release. You can set your block off to the side. All right, so take a moment to enjoy the breath. And then we're going to bring our hands behind the right knee. If you are not able to reach behind your right knee, use your strap. Take a hold of the strap and rest your elbows on the floor and work from here, okay? So we're gonna start with that thigh as close to perpendicular to the floor as possible. We're gonna flex the ankle and point the toe. Flex the ankle, point the toe, and then roll the ankle. Release any creaking or cracking there. And then we're going to come into working the hips. So you can let your foot just be relaxed now. Focusing on the right thigh, we're going to gently press the thigh into your hands or your strap. Again, just a little muscle energy. Working in the hip and the low back and the lower belly. We're going to count that down. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Soften and release. Allow the foot to come to the floor, and it might feel good to do just a very slight knee rock. Just a very small range of motion. Rocking the knees back and forth, soften and release the hips and glutes. Enjoy your breath. And then let's come back again to the knees are still, and we're going to lift that right leg. Bring your strap to the back of the knee, or bring the hands interlaced to the back of the knee. Once again, gently press the thigh into the hands or the strap. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Bring the foot to the floor. Maybe just a little bit of rocking of that sacral area, the far low back, as you gently rock the knees side to side. And here we go, one more time on the right side. Lift the knee, strap to the back of the knee or hands to the back of the knee. And then you can add a little bit more muscle energy, push the leg into the strap or the hands, but the strap or the hands are holding it steady. We're working some isometrics here. Feel the muscles building, a muscle energy building on that right hip and glute. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and soften and release. Maybe rock the hips gently, moving the knees side to side, soften and release there. And then we're going to do a stretch for that right side. So straighten your left leg out. Bring your hands to your abdomen. And we're going to open the hip. Let that knee travel out to the right as far as you can. Then draw that knee up towards you. Bring your hands to the knee and hug it into the chest. So instead of just pulling the knee straight up to the chest, we're opening the hip, rotating that hip out to the side to draw the knee up. And again, if you are not able to reach the front of your knee, you can use a strap at the front of the knee. Softening and releasing the hip on the right side. One more round of breath here. And then to release, big breath into the belly. Exhale, pull your belly in, engage your belly as you super slowly bring that foot back down to the floor. Okay, bending the left leg. Let's get the other side going now. So bring your strap or your hands interlaced to the back of the left thigh. And let's take a moment here to flex the ankle, point the toe, flex the ankle, point the toe, and then do some circles with that ankle. Reverse the direction. And then we'll come into the work for our hip here. Again, the arms are holding the thigh steady, and we're gently pressing the thigh into the strap or the hands, building a little bit of muscle energy in the left hip and glutes and lower belly. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Soften and release. Allow that foot to come to the floor. Maybe very gently rock the knees side to side. And then let's go again, bending the leg. Take a hold of the thigh. Gently press the leg in. You can go just a little bit more with your muscle energy here if that's comfortable for your hips. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release the foot to the floor. Gently rock the hips, knees side to side. Let your breath be steady and easy. And then one more time, bending that leg strap or hand to the back of the knee. Add the muscle energy, maybe a little bit more this time. Press the thigh into the strap, the back of the thigh that is. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release. Shake the knees out side to side. Soften and release that far low back. And then we're going to do the stretch. So open the thigh. Let that knee travel out to the side. Right leg stays where it is. Draw that left knee up towards your armpit and then bring it into the chest. So we're opening the hip out to the left, bringing the knee up to the armpit, and then hugging it into the chest. Oh, release that right foot, right leg to the floor. Enjoy your breath. One more round of breath here. And then release the foot to the floor, bending the legs, arms out to your side. Now this time, see if you can bring your right ankle to the left knee. Big breath into the belly. And as you exhale, release those legs over to the right. Feel the right glutes meeting the floor. Soften and release the right hip and glutes. Enjoy your breath. Feel that lengthening on the left side of the torso from the armpit down through the left hip. One more round of breath here. And then to come out, big breath in. Exhale, pull the belly in, lift the knees back up. Switch the cross of the leg. So we're going to lift the left foot, left ankle comes to the outside of the right knee. Big breath in. Exhale, draw your belly in and release the knees over to the left. Bring your awareness to the left hip and glutes where it's meeting the floor. Soften and release those muscles. And then feel into the length from the right armpit into the right hip. Enjoy your breath. One more round of breath here. And then big breath into the belly. Exhale, draw the belly in, lift the knees back up, uncross the legs, bring your hands to your knees. If you can't reach your knees, bring the strap to the knees, elbows to the floor holding the strap, and we're going to rock the pelvis. Big breath in. Exhale, draw the belly in, squeeze, squeeze, pull the knees into the chest, feel the low back pressing into the floor. Inhale, release, knees move away. Exhale, squeeze the knees in, soften and release your shoulders, feel the back pressing into the floor or the bed. Inhale, knees away. And now take the knees wide as your strap will allow, or as wide as you can with your hands on your knees. Gently stretching the groin, and then bring the knees back together. Release the feet to the floor, stretch out, close your eyes, and enjoy your breath. Take a moment to notice the difference in the way your hips and your glutes and low back feel now. Then we're going to do a brief shavasana here at the end of our practice. Eyes closed. Bring your awareness to your breath. Pull the breath in through the nose, expanding to the count of three. And exhale to five. Soften and release your hips, glutes, and low back. Continuing to focus on the breath. We take a couple minutes to be in stillness, present, focused on the experience of our breath and our body at this time. If your mind drifts, remember you can always count the breath into three, out to five, softening and releasing with the exhale. bring a little movement back into your body. Maybe wiggle the fingers and toes, roll the ankles, turn the head side to side. If you're ready to transition off of the bed or off of your mat, remember to roll to your side first. Take a moment to pause there. Eyes still closed, continuing to soften and release. We want to come out of Shavasana very slowly so we can hold on to the feelings of ease as we move into the rest of our day. Big breath into the belly. Gently pull the belly in as you lengthen your spine and push yourself up to sitting at the edge of your bed or sitting on the floor or sitting in a chair. Continuing to, you don't have to do your legs like this. This is the most comfortable position for my hip at this time. So once you've come to seated, close your eyes again, turn your focus inward to the breath. Remember, you can take this relaxing breathing pattern with you through your day, taking a moment now and then to just center yourself, bring in the relaxing breath, softening and releasing before you move forward with your day. Inhale to three, exhale to five. And gently open your eyes. We'll close chanting Om one time. I like to bring my hands to prayer position at the heart. It feels a lot more mindful, and I can feel the vibrations of my chanting moving through my heart center, just lightly placing my thumbs here. You might give it a try. Pull the breath in. Thank you so much for joining us for this gentle bed floor practice for hips and glutes. Namaste. I'm going to come up to the chat window just in case somebody wants to pop in and say hello, or if you have any questions.